Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to import images automatically into Adobe InDesign, and we're going to use something called Data Merge. All right, let's get started. First, you'll need to prepare your data file. I'm going to use Google Sheets for this because everybody has access to it for free. You'll just need to make a free account. In the first cell, A1, you'll want to include a column for images, and the header for this column should start with an apostrophe, then at image. This is how InDesign will recognize that these are image files instead of, say, text. Next, we need to list the file paths of our images. So I've saved my images in a folder, and to get the file names, it's a little bit of a weird process. I'm going to open Text Edit. I'll go to File, New. I'm going to make this a plain text document by going to Format, Make Plain Text. Then I can just click and drag those images onto my plain text document. And that will give me all the file paths. So I'll copy that. Then I'll come back to Google Sheets and I'll paste. That'll put each one in a separate cell. But the thing is, all we need is this part right here, /images/, and then the file name. So I need to remove all of this stuff. To do that, I'll copy one of them, and then I'll go to Edit, Find and Replace. I'll paste that. I'll get rid of this stuff at the end. I want to find all of those and replace with nothing. So I'll choose Replace All, and done. And now I'm left with exactly what I need. Now on a PC, it's a little bit easier. All you have to do is select all your images, right-click, and choose Copy as Path. And then go to Google Sheets and paste with Control V. Now I have a feeling you might want a caption underneath each image. So I'm going to add a caption column right here. And I'll copy these and paste them. I'm just going to use the file name. This time I'll do a Find and Replace and just get rid of images in this specific range that I highlighted and replace with nothing. So we'll replace all. Now we're left with just the file names. So this name will be underneath each image. Now I'll export my CSV file. I'll go to File, Download, and CSV, comma separated values. I'll just put that here in the same folder as my images, so it'll be easy to find. And I just moved all that other stuff that is not relevant to this video, so this will be easier to look at. So we have our images folder, and then we have our CSV file. Now we need to make a InDesign file. So I'm gonna go to File, New. I'll click Print and choose Letter, and then I'll Create. Now I want my first image to be right about here. And then I want my text for the caption to be right underneath it. And I'm gonna go ahead and center this. That's right up here at the top of your screen. So the caption will always be centered underneath. Now I'll go to Window, Utilities, and Data Merge. This will bring up this Data Merge window. We'll click on the little hamburger menu up here and choose Select Data Source. And then I'm going to navigate to our CSV file and open it. And I'm going to leave all of this the same and say OK. So now you can see we've got image and caption, and those are the two column names in our spreadsheet. I've clicked on the rectangle frame, and I'm going to choose image for that. And so you can see what it looks like, and then I'll put caption here. Now, if you don't like how the caption looks, you can change the font. I'm going to go ahead with Montserrat. Maybe we'll make it Montserrat regular. And you can also change the size. I'll make it 10 points. Next, I'll click on the Create Merge Document button. Okay, I want to merge all the records, and instead of having one single record per page, I'm going to put multiple records. I'll come to Multiple Record Layout, and I can click Preview to see what's going to happen. I'm going to zoom out a little bit. Now I can change the spacing between columns. I'll just increase that. And then also between the rows. And this looks good, so I'll say OK. It's giving me an alert that's saying there's no text that's basically getting cut off, so everything's looking good. We'll say OK. And now you can see what it's done. We've got page one with all of these images. We've also got page two with the rest of our images. So it will make as many pages as you need. And if I hit W, you can see what it looks like. So we can save this file as auto images and put it with the rest of our stuff in the same folder. So really your setup needs to be a folder with an InDesign file, an images folder, whatever you want to call it. This is where the file paths come in, and it will be /images/, or whatever you happen to call it. And then you'll have your CSV file here too. So now we could export this as a PDF and print it if we wanted to. We could print straight from InDesign if we needed to. So here's our PDF. And that's it. All right, if you liked this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you.